Here, I will discuss about steady state model and dynamic model and give example to differentiate. A steady state model. This describes the process outputs under stationary conditions of input variables. So, the performance equations for the design of heat transfer and mass transfer equipments are based on steady state models. Dynamic model. This describes the output response when there is change in one or more inputs. It is under unsteady state condition and is also called transient state. What is the use of developing dynamic model? To exercise control system design. For control system design, first step is to develop dynamic model of the process, because when there is change in input, control system tries to negotiate the disturbed processes and brings back to new steady state. So to do these activities, it needs a dynamic model. To diagnose operational fault in a plant, so to run the plant safely. So now I will take a few examples to show the difference between a steady state model and a dynamic model. Let us consider a T-joint. So, for a T-joint, we are giving two inputs, that is Q1 and Q2, which are the mass flow rates, and X1, X2 are the solute concentration, and there is an output having Q3 mass flow rate and X3 solute concentration. Here I am assuming that mixing takes place in negligible time and negligible volume. So there is an assumption, negligible time and volume. Now under steady state condition, the overall mass balance will be Q1 plus Q2 are the inlet mass flow rates, which will add up on to give Q3, and the individual solute mass balance will be Q1 X1, which is a solute concentration, plus Q2 X2 is equal to Q3 X3. So these are the model equations for steady state. Now, under dynamic state, in dynamic state, these equations are still sufficient because the responses are instantaneous, as I given the assumption that it takes place in a negligible time. So the reaction will be instantaneous. So these two equations are still valid. Let us consider it as equation 1 and 2. So here, there will be same equations. But in process plants, we won't be using T-joints because there will be too many fluctuations in the exit concentration. So we will consider a CSTR where there will be perfect mixing. So a CSTR has two inputs having mass flow rates Q1, Q2 and solute concentrations X1, X2. The output is positioned in such a height, let me call it as H, and the output has a Q3 mass flow rate and X3 solute concentration. As this reactor consists a definite volume of V. Now, we will model this equation under steady state. Still, the equations for T-joint steady state are valid here. So, Q1 plus Q2 equal to Q3, Q1 X1 plus Q2 X2 is equal to Q3 X3. Now, under dynamic state, has it discussed that in dynamic change, there will be change in one or more inputs. So let us take, there is a change in the first input. Now here, there are two changes to be taken place. Either mass flow rate or solute concentration. Let us take that mass flow rate changes. So the mass flow rate Q1 is changed to Q1 plus Z. And for this change in the output, this Z flow rate will be added. So whatever extra is added here, it is coming as an output. So there won't be any accumulation here. And the equation 1 is still valid for dynamic state. That is Q1 plus Q2 equal to Q3. So if mass flow rate changes, there won't be any change in equation. Now let us take that solute concentration changes. That is X1 is changed to some Y1. So when it comes into the reactor, it takes some time to mix up and come with a different concentration of Y3. So to account this time, we will be adding a differential term in the equation. So the solute mass balance will be Q1 X1 plus Q2 X2 is equal to Q3 X3 plus V dx3 by dt. In CSTR, the bulk concentration and exit concentration are same. So for total change in the exit stream should require definite amount of time to complete or to reach new steady state. So to this gradual change of exit concentration may be accounted in the equation, and we have introduced a new term. So in the T joint, I told that the same equations are valid because there is a negligible time and volume. So let us see here. As in T joint, there is a negligible volume. So this will be 0. So for a T joint only, this is the equation. But for CSTR, the equation, in this equation, a differential term is also added, because there is a gradual change in the exit concentration. So this is the difference between a steady state model and a dynamic model.
Thanks for watching my video, and post your views or doubts in the comment section.